present day, my dear students in English A. I'm here again, your teacher, Mrs. Virtudazo, to guide you in Module 3, and it is all about to model verbs. Ano nga bang model verbs? Try to recheck and review, starting from recall in your module. So there is a given example, the conversation of James and Mecca. Try to check and get all those underlined words. They are all models. There are several questions. What do you call the underlined words? Why do we use models? Can and could, may and might, will and would, shall and should, must, had better, ought, though, there and need. A lot of models. Well, model verbs, man, model auxiliaries, or model auxiliary verbs, they are all models. Pare-parehas lang yan. Iba-iba ang tawag, pero lahat yan models. Ano nga ba yung usually nagagamit natin? Yung could, may, might, can, should, will. So, ito yung examples. Yung concept niya, maaaring possibility, permission, o baka naman request. There are a lot of characteristics of model verbs used with a singular or plural subject, may be used as a verb, may present, may past, pero syempre may mga expression din siya, baka naman na obligation na siya, o talagang strong request. Itong model verbs ay hindi lang yung usually natin nagagamit. May ilan din na bago sa pandinig natin. They are also model verbs. Have to, used to, yung ought to, gagamit na lang tayo ng should or must, but it could also be ought to. May, must, might, baka naman sila ay possibility ba o obligation niya ba. So yung model verbs will be seen or come before the main verb. The main verbs are in bold letters like can or do, could erupt, may get, might reach, or give, would hate. Yun yung mga examples na nakita nyo sa inyong module. Can you show me your picture? No, I can't. Ito yung sa question. From positive, ang answer maging negative, or kung ang question ay negative, answer naman ang magiging positive. So, yun yung affirmative na maaaring may not na siya, so negative na siya. Ayan. Ito ang nagaling sa EnglishStudier.com. So let me just cite them or acknowledge. Ito yung madalas na ginagamit. Can, could, may, might, must, should, will. So sometimes we think na yung could past tense lang yung can, yung would past tense ng will, should past tense ng shall, pero hindi lang yun as past tense ng verb. Ito rin ay maaaring na nag-emphasize ng kung ano yung ini-intend niya as a moral verb. We shall not let them do this to us. Yan. Our model verb and WH question, andyan lahat yung questions sa page na yan. At dito, will be given some words or some models that you're going to use in a sentence. So, dyan na kayo mag-start na mag-sagot like dun sa let's analyze, let's try bago kayo dumating sa pinaka-final output. Mamaya manalaman natin yun yung let's create. So, look at this. Let's apply. Andyan yung mga pictures. Yung images na to could help you to compose or write your own sentence. So, you're going to provide 5 to 8 sentences. So, what about in this next activity? In this activity here, it is entitled Let's Analyze. So, you're going to analyze each sentence. Bawat number meron doon. So, kailangan mas malino sa inyo. Ano nga ba yung modal verbs? For example, can at saka yung could. Can is offering while could is suggesting. Can could be permission, ability, possibility, or request. And could could be ability, possibility, or request. But they are both permission. They are both possibility and request. But sometimes we usually think that the can is the present and the could is the past tense of can. What about the for the possibility? May, might, could. They are the verbs, they are the models usually known as a verb or maybe adverb for possibility. I might study math, I may pass chemistry, and a lot more. What about the obligation? Must, should, have to. Ito ba ay kailangan? So, obligation talaga, kaya must. With a strong request. Or with a strong command. Or order. So, yung obligation na yun, gagamit tayo ng should, have to, ought to. So, yun yung mga models na pwedeng gamitin. So, let's try. Let's try natin. Makikita natin dyan kung paano tayo gagamit ng models. So, by filling the blank. So, may blank dyan. I-fill up natin. Anong mas appropriate na model ang kailangan gamitin. As the last part of the module, ito na yung final output na tinatawag na nating let's create. With this final output, could able to compose our own writing, could write our own composition. So, ito yung song in any tune. For example, katunog ng I can ni Regine Velasquez or yung Doremi before. Or baka naman ito yung katunog ng mga sikat na bagong kanta ngayon. But with this composition, gagamitin siyempre ng models.